The next demo is one of the most important exercises in the entire course, and it's about automating charts using offset, count A, and named ranges. Now, the reason this lecture is so important is because functions like offset and count A are the basic building blocks to creating truly dynamic charts and graphs. Basically, they allow you to create fluid, dynamic chart source data rather than traditional fixed arrays, which really lets you bring your visualizations to life and integrate some much more advanced functionality. So head to the Automatic Chart Updates tab, and as you can see here, we've got a simple data set with two columns, date and temperature. And let's say my job is to update a trending temperature chart with every day that I collect new data. What you could do is select cell A1 through B24 and insert a line chart just like normal, and that's totally fine. The only challenge is that as you add more days worth of data and manually enter new temperatures, the chart doesn't know to update because, as you can see, its source data is fixed through row 24. So it doesn't see any new data points that are added beneath that. One option in Excel is to convert or format this data range as a table and then tab down to add new rows to that table. But I'm going to show you an approach that's a little more flexible and a lot more powerful, and that's using those offset and count A functions in the form of named ranges. So what we need to do here is head up to our Formulas tab and click the Define Name button. And we're going to do this twice, first for our X values, which are our dates, and second for our Y values, which are temperatures. Let's start with dates. So I'll actually just name it dates. We can scope this named array to a particular tab or to the workbook as a whole. That's fine for now. And here's where we would typically see a fixed array of cells serving as the source data for our chart. What we want to do is delete that and write an offset function. And what offset does, to quickly summarize, is it tells Excel, I want you to start at this particular cell that you define. I want you to move down a certain number of rows, left or right a certain number of columns, and return an array of cells with a particular height and width defined by the number of rows and the number of columns. And the beautiful thing is that you can nest functions within there so that instead of hard coding the specific dimensions of the resulting array, you can make it fluid and dynamic. And that's exactly what we're going to do using the COUNTA function. So with offset, it's a little bit tricky to see because when you're typing functions here in the name manager, Excel doesn't help you along step by step. So watch carefully. Luckily, I've written a few of these, so I know the steps. But basically, we're going to open the parenthesis, and the first piece of our offset function is the starting cell. So for our dates array, the starting cell will be the first date in the array, which is cell A2. And then as we comma over, we'll move to each component of the function. The next piece of the offset function says, do you want to move down or up any rows from that starting point? In this case, no. You want to keep that as 0. That's our starting point, and it always will be. The next comma says, do you want to move left or right from that starting point? Again, the answer is no, which brings us to the next component, which is the height of our resulting array. And this is where we want count A, because while we could say, okay, we want an array with a height of 25 rows and hard code a 25 in there, then when we add new data, it's still going to read the first 25 rows and serve the same purpose as a traditional fixed array, which really doesn't get us anywhere. So instead of hard coding a number there, we're going to use the count A function, which basically counts all of the cells within a given range that contains some value, so any non-blank cells. And the range that we're going to look in this case, I'll open the parenthesis and select all of column A and close the parenthesis. So now the count A function is saying, look at the entire column A, tell me how many cells within column A contain something. So in this case, the count A function would look at the entire column A and count 24 cells that contain data, which is almost what we want, except we don't want to count the header. So we just need to subtract 1 here and comma over to the final component of the function, which is what's the width of the resulting array in terms of the number of columns. In this case, just going to enter 1 because our x values are all contained within a one-dimensional array that's one column wide. So I can close that parenthesis out. That wraps up our offset and count A function. I can press OK. And now we're going to do the exact same thing for our temperatures in column B. So define name, we'll call it temperatures. Workbook scope is fine. And again, we're going to type an offset function here. In this case, our starting point is cell B2. We don't want to move any rows. We don't want to move any columns from that starting point. The height of our resulting array is count A, in this case of column B, minus 1 for the header, comma, 1 column wide, close the parenthesis. Boom, there you go. So now we have named arrays to define in a much more dynamic way how many values we need to plot from columns A, our x values, and columns B, our y values. So the final step is just adjusting our chart source by selecting the data and starting with temperature, which is our y values. We can edit that series. As you can see here, the series is currently fixed at cells B2 through B24. So that range is never going to change, and it's never going to see any new data points that get added beneath it. All I need to do is delete everything after that exclamation point and type temperatures, which is the named array that we just created. Press OK. Same exact thing for our horizontal x-axis. It's fixed at A2 through A24. I'm going to delete everything after the exclamation point and type dates. Press OK. And when I do that, you won't see anything change initially, but as you add more data and type in more temperatures, you can see now that our chart is automatically updating with those new data points. And if you select the line or select the series, you'll now see that the series reflects all of the data through row 27 now. So there you have it, quick primer on using offset and count day functions within named ranges to create automatically updating charts with fluid dynamic source data.